We're on video.
Good afternoon, everybody. How are you? This is Doug E. Fresh, Motor City's Trusted Car Guy. Folks, I just want to introduce you guys to somebody. This right here, this young man right here, this is Rick Reschy. Rick Reschy has been in the business here for 34 years selling cars. And look at that beast. Look at that first car of his, man. That is his. That's his dream car. So what we're going to do, folks, in a little while, is later on today, we're going to put Rick Reschy and his beautiful vehicle right here out to the pasture. That's right. He's going out to the pasture. He's going to be a free man. Him and the wife are going to travel the world and do everything that they want to do. But, folks, I just want to come online real quick and show you this beautiful car and come over here and do an interview with this guy. Mr. Rick, how are you? Say hello to the world.
Hey, Dougie. How are you?
Man, I am so fan-flipping-tastic, sir. I don't know what to do.
It's a wonderful day in the neighborhood. Today, we celebrate my 34 years in the car business. They've allowed me to put my DeSoto in the showroom. This is the 1961 DeSoto. It's the last design from Virgil Exner at Chrysler Corporation. This car was built in October of 1960. Production of DeSoto ceased altogether in November of 1960. So the old joke between DeSoto people is how many 61s were built in 1961? And the answer is absolutely none, because they ended production in 1960. So there were 911 two doors like mine built. There were about 2,200 four doors. And that was the very end. DeSoto started in 1928. It was an idea by Walter P. Chrysler himself to imitate the design and the way the marketing had gone for General Motors and Mr. DeWitt. And what he did was he had different models. So he had a Chrysler, he had a Plymouth, he had a DeSoto, he had an Imperial. He lacked one for the Pentastar, and that happened when he purchased Dodge from the Dodge brothers. It also gave him trucks. So Mr. Walter P. is a genius, and he was a genius in automotive production and marketing and so on. His theory was always this: get the best engineers, they'll make the best car, and all he had to do was market it. When the DeSoto was introduced in 1929, it sold more cars than any car that had been introduced prior to that. And again, 29 was the first year. They were built in 1928. That's why we say the DeSotos ran from 28 to 61. This car here is powered by a 361 V8. It's a two-barrel carburetor. It's not a hot rod, but boy, it certainly does turn some eyes when you take it down the road.
It is a pretty car, Rick, I'll tell you that, man. It is a pretty car.
So, this is it.
All right, everybody. Well, this is Mr. Rick, and he is saying farewell tonight. So if you guys got nothing going on tonight from 6 to 8, we got band, we got food. Rick is doing some dancing, man, and he's got some moves. So let me tell you, he might show me how to do the Dougie. So anyways, folks, everybody say goodbye to Rick. We're going to miss the guy. We love him to death, and he did a phenomenal job for Suburban Chrysler, Dodge, Jeep, Ram, Ann Arbor, and everybody else. Thank you. Take care. Bye-bye.